I'm always going to be Meg. Meghan Markle's makeup artist shares her heartwarming response after he asked the very cool bride what he should call her after the royal wedding. A lot of things might have changed in Meghan Markle's life now that she's officially a royal, but there is one thing the new Duchess is intent on keeping the same: her name. Her makeup artist and friend Daniel Martin, who created her understated look for her wedding to Prince Harry on Saturday, told People he asked Meghan, who has been his friend for almost a decade, how he should refer to her now that she's a royal. I asked her that. Do I bow to you? I don't want to disrespect you, but I've known for almost 10 years. What's up? He said. She started laughing and she said, I'm always going to be Meg. Meg. The makeup artist, who is based in New York City, still pledged to be respectful and know his protocol next time he sees the Duchess of Sussex. Daniel, whose A-list clients have included Jessica Alba and Elizabeth Moss, is based in New York and works as a brand ambassador for Dior, as well as the creative color consultant for Honest Beauty, Jessica's label. On the day of the royal wedding, he was one of four people who assisted Meghan as she got ready to walk down the aisle, in addition to her mother, Doria Ragland, her dress designer, Claire Wade Keller, and her hairstylist, Serge Normant. Meghan played 1950s, chilled music on Spotify, and Doria was in good spirits, Daniel told the magazine. As for the bride, he described her as relaxed and true to herself in the moments that preceded her wedding ceremony. She didn't seem nervous. She was very cool. She was regular Meghan, he said. I think we were nervous, but we didn't want to make her nervous, so it was very chilled. Of course, brides have nerves, but if we didn't put so much expectation on it, it wouldn't have made her nervous. It was very even, very easy. Meghan's wedding day makeup was a simple, minimalist look with a light smoky eye and a pale pink lip. The bride let her natural freckles show and had a healthy, glowing complexion. Her defined eyebrows gave structure to her face, while her peachy lips gave a fresh touch to the overall look. Daniel was smitten with Meghan's simple Givenchy gown. It was also easy. It didn't hit us that she was getting married until she got the dress on, he said. The makeup artist, who found the dress so beautiful and so architectural, added, the spectacle of the veil and the crown, and it was, oh my goodness, this is really happening. Daniel also revealed the final sentence he and Meghan exchanged before the ceremony. Nothing really hit any of us until we got there and we saw the people and the magnitude of everything, he recounted. The last thing we said to each other was, we'll see you on the other side. After the ceremony, Daniel saw Meghan again for touch-ups, before she posed with Harry for their official wedding photos. That's when I started crying, he said. It was the first time I was able to be there in person. It was almost like she looked at me and said, what did you think? How did it go? And I lost it. Daniel, who met Meghan in 2011, has also revealed that he was among the first to know about Harry and Meghan's engagement. Meghan and I communicate a lot through text because I travel for work, and because of the time difference between the both of us, it's hard to get on the phone, he told Elle. So she sent me a text asking what I was doing the weekend of May 19th. I was like, I may be in Cannes for the film festival, but what's up? And she sent me the bride and groom emoji right back, and I literally dropped my phone. Then she sent me the SHH emoji back so I couldn't let anyone know. The Duchess makeup look, he said, was the result of a very collaborative process. She's extremely decisive and I know exactly what she wants, he said. She's very open and loves makeup, so it's always been fun playing dress up with her. Modernity was a key factor in crafting the look, which was meant to go with Meghan's structural, yet feminine dress. The linear line through the boat neck created a framing of her face from her collarbone up. If Meghan had much more makeup on, her face would have been the focus and not the gracefulness of her dress, he said. It would have been distracting, and that's what you don't want when the dress is the main attraction. Makeup should be the finishing touch to the dress, never the other way around, especially on your wedding day. As for touch-ups, Daniel said Meghan used blot papers and lipstick to refresh her look throughout the day.